Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to quickly transform simple black and white graphics into techno-inspired logo-like shapes. I'll also show you how to add color. Open a simple black and white graphic you'd like to use. Clipart generally works well for this purpose. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill it with white, and since white is your background color, press Ctrl-Delete on Windows or Command-Delete on a Mac. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command-J. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Pattern. Open the pattern thumbnails. If you don't see this one, click the gear icon and click Reset Patterns. Click OK to reset it with the default patterns. Click this icon, which is called Vertical Line 1. For the scale percentage, type in 750 and click OK. Go to Select and Color Range. Choose Shadows and click OK. Click off the eyeball next to the pattern to hide it and click the thumbnail of the layer below it to make it active. We'll fill the selection with black, and since black is the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. Hide this layer and the layer below it. Go back to Select and Color Range. Click OK. The shape of your graphic is now a selection. Make these two layers visible and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the grid. Next, we'll make a composite snapshot of your image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Go to Filter, Other, and Minimum. Make the radius 6 pixels and the preserve roundness. Then click OK. The general shape looks good, but if you look closely at the grid, the ends of many of them are a bit ragged or asymmetrical. To address this, we'll create a custom brush that we'll use to correct it. Press Ctrl or Command Z to undo your last step. Go to File and New. Make the width and the height 20 pixels each and the resolution 72 pixels per inch. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill it with black. Open your pencil tool and go to Edit and Define Brush Preset. We'll use the default brush name. Open back up your document and open your brush picker. The last thumbnail on the panel will be the square shape that we saved as a brush. Press Enter or Return and press X on your keyboard to invert your foreground and background colors. Now, white is the color of your custom brush. Press Z to open your zoom tool and zoom into the grid. Press B to open your custom brush and click the ends that look a bit ragged or asymmetrical. To move your image on the canvas, press and hold the space bar and drag your image. As soon as you release the space bar, your cursor reverts back to your custom brush. Continue until all the ends of the lines are squared off. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. To repeat the last filter you used, press Ctrl or Command F. All the lines on your grid should now look symmetrical. If there are any that aren't, undo the filter and use your custom brush to square off any remaining ragged edges that you may have overlooked. Then, repeat the filter. Next, I'll show you how to quickly make your lines in color. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Gradient. Open the Gradient Picker. I'll choose the Spectrum Gradient, however, you can experiment with any of them. I'll make the style linear and the angle 0 degrees. For now, I'll leave the scale at 100%. Change the blend mode to screen. Notice the red colors on the end of the spectrum aren't visible. This is because the gradient goes from one side of your document to the other side. To include the entire spectrum gradient inside your shape, we need to reduce the scale of the gradient. To do this, double-click on the gradient thumbnail to open the gradient fill and highlight the scale amount. Press the down arrow on your keyboard until all the colors are visible. To see it over a black background, change the blend mode to multiply and make the layer directly under the gradient active. Invert it by pressing Ctrl or Command I. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.